the hospital bed. I helped him turn so the cancer medicine could spread more evenly. His eyes welled and cracked like fortune cookies. Inside read, "Life is short, but being alive is the longest thing you will ever do. Proceed accordingly." If I'd attempted this homage to my father 10 years ago, probably would have consisted more of those things that drove me away. Hate and blame more than just mere symptoms of childhood angst, but the language I learned to speak in effort to explain how my father's absence from my formative years made me feel. You see, I once considered my father's DNA to be a cancer in me. Understanding the helix to be doubled, I never dreamed of losing myself completely, only half. A man now, I realize my thinking was the cancer. Forgiveness is medication. I'm still waiting for it to spread evenly. Always with the wrong bottle in hand from birth, my father showed me the image of addict. Resembled something like a court jester juggling knives. One blade for family, one blade for work, one for the military that never treated him as equal, one for the father that died when he was 10, another for the mother that was never the same. All the while spiraling down towards the greatest come to Jesus moment ever. 16-year-old son in the back seat as wife picks him up from jail after his second DUI. My father has been sober now for over 15 years. My father was an alcoholic. I was a cokehead. They say parents want children to grow up, achieve feats greater than their own. I don't believe this is what they had in mind. And I've spent years mortified of mirrors for having this image projected back on me. Sought a new likeness at the bottom of empty whiskey bottles and clear plastic baggies. Mainline hate and blame until I became so high, I had nowhere to go. Rock bottom in the sky, I landed in my father's arms through falling. I've come to realize that just as my father did not ask for this predilection towards addiction, that neither had I, that hate and blame are just new ways to get high for those of us not willing to change. And that which took him 20 years only took me 3 years, because for the last 15, he has shown me what redemption looks like. Well, a life no longer lived in regret looks like. I refuse to be 20 years down the line, racing down Route 95, a bat out of a homemade hell, stopped by a cop for going 95, exclaiming out of the window of my car that, like all men, my father's dying. But like most men, I never told him I loved him. Never told him I forgive him. Never said, "I forgive you, Pops, as I hope you have forgiven me." Never said, "I knew one of those blades you juggled had love for family inscribed in it." I realize neither side of this reflection will ever be perfect. I am no longer scared of mirrors, because life is short, but it is the longest thing you will ever do. Proceed accordingly.